On November 23, 1939, Jewish citizens of Poland were forced to wear badges that marked them as Jewish citizens. Now, almost 75 years later, on November 19th, Donald Trump, a leader in the GOP polls, suggested we mark Muslims in the same manner. To those watching this video, this probably sounds like an isolated thing. Trump is crazy. Who could possibly agree with him, right? But he has supporters. He has a 34% favorable rating, up 14% from just 6 months ago and on the rise. There's more parallels lining up between now and World War II. Some have suggested to set up a refugee camp to keep them segregated from our populace. Sound familiar? A much wider spread idea is that we should just not accept refugees entirely. Many people argue that this could be the way to keep out the handful of terrorists that might be hiding in the 4 million Syrian refugees seeking shelter from a war-torn and terrorized country. This is basically sentencing these refugees, these people, to death, seeing as the Syrian civil war since its beginning in 2010 has already taken over 250,000 lives and takes an average of 100 to 200 lives a week. Besides, there's really no reason to not accept them. The US has a crazy in-depth processing system that takes up to 2 years for each refugee to go through, and US News claims that the Syrian refugees could possibly even increase our economic status as a country. So here's why you should care. Right now, the Syrian refugee crisis, the biggest refugee crisis of our generation by far, is showing early parallels to World War II and not the good heroic kind. Even worse, some Americans want to leave these 4 million people to just die. Families, children and parents, and brothers and sisters. Is that really the American thing to do? To leave our brothers behind bloodied with war? The only way to fix this is for us, the people, to speak up. Do whatever you can to get your voice heard about this issue. Whether it's a tweet, an email to a local Congress member, a letter, a video, anything. Today, I'm thankful for a time where we get to fight for our voice. I'm thankful for an outlet like YouTube where I get to have my voice heard and shared. Today, I'm thankful that if we band together, we can make a change in the world. For the better.